Hola amores, welcome back to my channel. For today's video, we're going to be talking about the Negros Muscogos, or the Black Seminoles of Mexico. And of course, this video is also in continued celebration of Black History Month. So this topic was suggested to me by someone under a comment section of another video, so shout out to the person that requested this topic. The Muscogos, also known as Negros Muscogos, are an Afro-descendants group in Coahuila, Mexico. Centered on the town of El Nacimiento in the Musquis municipality, the group are descendants of Black Seminoles escaping the threats of slavery in the United States. Their ancestors were African Americans who escaped from the United States to Mexico in the 19th century, fleeing the slave trade for a desert village at the base of the Sierra Madre Mountains. They were called the Muscogos, a group of roughly 60 Black families who spoke and prayed in English as they hid from the white men who wanted to put them back in shackles. These slaves had first fled to Florida, which was then owned by the Spanish, who generally allowed escaped slaves to live as free men and women. Some lived alongside members of the Seminole tribe and eventually became known as Black Seminoles, or in Spanish, Muscogos. Because of the mixed Afro-Indian heritage, many Black Seminoles were considered indigenous under U.S. law and avoided the Negro label. However, what they weren't able to escape was the Negro treatment. The U.S. took control of Florida in 1821. 9 years later, President Andrew Jackson signed the Indian Removal Act, which forced Native tribes in the Southeast, including the Muscogos, along the Trail of Tears to Oklahoma. After the forced move of the Seminoles and the Black Seminoles from Florida to Indian Territory, they found themselves once again vulnerable to Southern slaveholders. In July 1850, 309 Muscogos escaped to Mexico, where slavery had been abolished decades earlier, crossing the border near what is now Eagle Pass, Texas. A group led by Seminole sub-chief Wildcat and Black Seminole chief John Horse, also known as Juan Caballo, moved to northern Mexico. The group settled at El Nacimiento in 1852, where they shared their duties as military colonists with a group of Kickapoo Indians who had accompanied them from the States. As they had in Florida and Oklahoma, the Black members of the Seminoles settled in their own village, close to that of their Seminole allies. They worked for the Mexican government to protect against Indian raids. Many of the Seminoles died from smallpox, and many of those remaining eventually returned to the United States along with some of the Black Seminoles. While many Muscogos were lured back to the U.S. after slavery ended, for those that stayed, the fight to preserve their culture lives on 160 years after their arrival in Mexico. Since then, their vocabulary has dissipated, replaced by the Spanish of northern Mexico. Droughts destroyed their farms. Drug cartels have inched closer to their village of Nacimiento de los Negros, whose name translates to Birth of the Blacks. The Muscogos celebrate Juneteenth, the holiday on June 19th that commemorates the abolition of slavery in the U.S. During the festivities, the community is visited by family members and Black Seminoles from Brackettville, Texas. Muscogo traditional dishes include sosque, a type of atole, telapun, bread made from camote, pumpkin or piloncillo empanadas, and pan de mortero. The traditional costume of the Muscogo woman is a long polka-dotted dress, an apron, and a handkerchief tied around the head.
Thank you. We see the people over here and still living over here in Nacimiento, all the colored people.
Es que no queremos dejar el costumbre, que no se debe dejar el tiempo, no se olvide el costumbre de nosotros.
Como nosotros tuvimos de nuestros abuelos, de nuestros padres.
Ya estamos cuarteadas.
Pero más cuarteadas.
Como quiera, nos sentimos orgullosas de llevarlo, aunque sea un poquito.
Nosotros nos llamamos los negros Muscogos. Los antepasados de nosotros fueron negras, nosotros somos negras. Según las pláticas que oímos de los antepasados, creo que ellos lucharon, ¿verdad?, para dejarnos esta tierra. Y estamos orgullosas, ¿verdad?, me siento orgullosa de ser negra, de pertenecer a esa sangre de negra.
As of 2016, the only pure Muskogo was 85-year-old Lucia Vasquez, this being a result of frequent outmarriage in the community. According to Homero Vasquez, an elderly Muskogo whose mother was from Chihuahua, starting in the 1930s, there was an influx of farmers to the region, resulting in an increase of marriage with outsiders. There is significant migration to other parts of Mexico and the United States of the young people of El Nacimiento due to a lack of opportunities. Afro-Seminole Creole is used for the Capeyuye and is spoken mostly by the elderly.
Soy negra, fea, pero clarigosa.
Pues mis madres vinieron, mis abuelos de allá con ella, de muchacha, corriendo de Estados Unidos cuando corrieron los indios, ¿viste? Por allá de Florida, pues creo yo que de la esclavitud.
Nomás dijo, we run, corrimos. Pues bueno, Dios no me dio licencia, preguntarle en qué corrieron, si a patín o cómo.
Ellos fueron esclavos de los gringos. Y los gringos, ¿verdad?, les daban órdenes a ellos que mataran a los Kickapoo. Pero cuando los negros vienen y encuentran a los Kickapoo en la orilla de la frontera, hubo un niño, un Kickapoo, que vio al jefe de los negros y les dijo, ¿verdad?, ya no nos maten. Entonces este negro fue conmovido y es como huyen juntos ellos.
Pues vinieron cuando vinieron los negros macos. Y pues lo llevamos muy bien lo llevamos con los indios Kickapoo. Yo aquí nací negra pura porque mi mamá era así como me ve a mí negra. Y todos sus hermanas y hermanos. Aquí nací, aquí me crié. Aquí me casé. Aquí enviudé y aquí estoy todavía, gracias a mi Dios.
In May 2017, the governor of Coahuila, Rubén Moreira Valdez, signed a decree that recognized the Tribu de los Negros Muskogos as a pueblo indígena de Coahuila, or translated, an indigenous population of Coahuila. He said that he hopes the Muskogos can begin receiving funds from the Instituto Nacional de Pueblos Indígenas, or the National Institute of Indigenous Peoples, by 2018. And that's it for this video, guys. As always, I hope that you all enjoyed it. Give this video a thumbs up, and of course, leave your comments down below. And I'll check you guys in the next one. Bye!